Race 6, the toast to the final race of the day. Yeah, 4 miles free and the rain is still pouring. One more bound, Bond, Dear Howells, two Canas, Steve Winton, three Niff, David Ladd, four Always Cruising Ems, five Eero, Dunkirk, PJ, Ha, six Ty, three Pontiful Racing and quite elusive Martin Lean. Just a field of seven, a disappointing field of seven. One is a national trial race, so Always Cruising, and the commentator's nightmare this, a long 4 mile free race, just seven runners. Well, disappointing turnout, quite elusive in third. Then comes Eero, Dunkirk, Taipin, War Bond and Neef. I know it's the summer holidays and all, and it's a break between the league, switching from SO6 to SO7. Hopefully next month, end of October, where I'm going to do trials for jump, trials for flat, 1-6 races of each. We'll have a few more entering, up some horses in the new league mode. Canans leads by a length, keep Always Cruising, because then a couple of weeks later we're in November and then we got what should be the start of the first SO7 league. So trainers, please try and get some horses into the trials next month. Give you a heads up in October, end of September, beginning of October, I'll run them of course, but yeah, need runners. And there at the back we lost Eero Dunkirk, and he's not a hero now to his trainer, so that just leaves me six horses to commentate, which I'll start doing in about 2 minutes time. Oh, that one in the pink is going well, that's Canans. Always Cruising is cruising along in second, quite elusive, it's not so elusive, he's a good looking grey in third, and then Taipin and then the Long Silks of Pontypool Racing lost their silks doing some silk alterations in the game of SO7 I did, but don't worry, he's back to the Welsh flag coloured silks now, and any runners in the future will be back in his right colours. Last is Warbound. I talked about silks, I made some for Manuel Villagran, the guy from Argentina who asked some for specific silks. You'll see him in the new season. He hasn't set any to trials with him, so and yeah, he asked for pineapples on a white silk. That's right, pineapples. I try my hardest to do pineapples. You'll see him next. He's quite pleased with him, so that's a new silk to look out for next season on the flat. I'll leave pineapples on a silk. Of course, Paul has got silk speed as well, with Strawbridge colours, white with the green hoop and white cap. And that's Paul's new league colours. Don't forget, if you want a designed silk, me or somebody else could do one for you. You have to be allocated a number in the silk for league trainers. Bring him up to in the 90s now. You just have to have the other league trainers who have their own silks in your file, so you see the German flag here, Holgas. That'll be one silk that you'll get with the, if you design your own silk, you have to have a number after that silk. Had a back down Howells, there's own silk in the orange there. who one person he designed, let me or someone know, and then I can allocate you a number and then send them to you, and then you can waste for that silk all the time, and that be your personalized silk in the league. I will start coming in pretty soon, but we're just rambling on. It's the last race. So my six of Toaster. I have to do six at Newmarket. Martin's deserted me. He's gone away for a couple of days. So he managed to get Ascot in, but these races came too late for him. And I'm hoping that Doug and Stu will come back commentating for the league, because I can't stand that commentator audio commentary we get with the game, and it's not the same without those vocal tunes of Stu and Doug and Martin. Make the racing experience much better. I jump in that one. Hopefully Martin Keynes may come back, and David Bombson might stick his hand up and say, I'll do some. Oh, league needs all the help we can. We've got room for commentators. We won't know about race running until we get to near the season, if we're going to need help with that. I'm so serious to be back with the flat handicapping, so that's always covered. And he did a cracking job, I must say. Serious, he's did a well good job on that handicap on the flat. I do the jumps. Anybody like to take that over? I'm willing to give it up to you. And I don't know, Tim Sandyman, of course, he might return. Although he's going quiet on that front. Jumping that. Oh, we lost quite elusive. He crawled all the way back to the back there, and now he's gone. So we're down to five, even less to contact on, but we're just a mile and one and a half to run. I think I better do some commentary. Always cruising, he's cruising along, being pressed by Canance in second. These are a couple lengths clear then of the third Neff. And then a gap to Taipin, who's 9 years old. And be surprised if he wins, really. He was just chucked in, because I hadn't done extreme distances on the jumps. I hadn't had time. And a big gap to War Bond. Darren, who's a regular to the league. And he really does plug away. That's always cruising. I think this is Em's runner. He's trying to get away here. Em's not really had a good trial so far, but I'm sure he'll be doing some nice game time now the lead mode has started. So the rest of us will, because we're now all in the same boat. We all start from the same place at the same time. So, you know, we all got chances to have a good season in the first season. They're mistaken fair by Taipin. But the front pair are sadly going away, and always cruising is cruised into a 4 to 5 length lead. And is really sprinting away from the second horse now, Neve, as they head up to the ditch. This is on the side bend. Are they jumping this? Oh, brilliant jump. And this horse, well, always cruising, it's cruising right away. It was a small field. We don't know how good this field is, but it's about 8 to 10 is clear. Neef in second, Taipin and War Bond on a battle for third and fourth. And Canisa, I can't see that when he's tailed off. The five runners are heading into straight. I don't think always cruising is going to be caught now. He's a long, long way clear. The jockey's even looking around, he's laughing at him. In second place, a good jump there from Neef. War Bond went past Taipin then at that jump, as Taipin made a mistake. Heading towards the final then, and this The cameraman has pulled his camera away. He has to try and get him all in the kinesis. So far behind, he can't get in the picture, but always cruising. It's a good win as we zoom back to the front. And afterwards, they always cruising. A good finish then to the trials for Ems. Neef in second. Typing got back up for the ring at a moment, and there is the struggling Canans. But that's a win for always cruising. That's Ems' only winner in the trials. And the Kamad is, I think he used to specialise in long distance runners. Ems. Well then, Craig, second was Neef, third, Taipin, 4-4-1.